Hi, everybody. One of my biggest critiques on maps is that you don't adjust your labels for your classes in your legend. So this video is going to show you how to do that. Here we're looking at a map of US counties by total population. So it's just the raw count of number of people in each county. Pretty straightforward. So if we were to switch into the layout view, and insert a legend. We just went through all our defaults to keep it simple. This is what our legend would pop out as. So first we'll address this stuff on top in another video, but in this video I want to focus on how to get these numbers to make sense or to be a little bit more readable. Because right now it's hard to figure out what these values actually are. So let's go back over to our data view just for the sake of time. And we will, to do this, we have to go to our properties, our layer properties window, and we'll go right to that symbology tab where we're seeing our population, we're seeing the range and values, and the labels. So first, we could reclassify this, but that's for another video too. All we're concerned about is how to make these labels look better. If you click on where it says label, so just anywhere right here, you can go ahead and click on the format labels. So you do have the option to reverse it if you wanted zero to be the darkest for some reason. But for us, we want the most population to be the darkest color. So we'll just go to that format labels option. You have a lot of options in the number format. Right now, we are dealing with numbers, but if this was values, maybe, median income, you could use currency and it would immediately change it to US dollars or whatever your localized currency is. So we're sticking with numbers because we're just using our numbers here, but you can see there's other options for rates, direction, percentage, etc. My biggest issue with our default is that these are raw counts. We don't have fractions of people, so we want to get rid of all of these zeros after the decimal point. And you can do that right here in this rounding section. So number of decimals, number of significant digits. We want to address that number of decimals and change that to zero. We don't want any because there's no fraction of people in this example. If you did have a fraction, you could change it to two. Maybe have two decimal places after the zero or however many you feel like you need. The other thing I wanted to change, well, we can just see how that changes it. So here we've gotten rid of all those decimal points. So far these numbers are getting a little bit easier to read. But let's keep going. Coming back to our format. The other thing I want to do is add in commas so I can see what these numbers are and I don't have to kind of trace my finger along to figure out this is 186,000 or that this is 10 million. So we have this option here to show thousand separators. That will give us the commas or the thousand separators for our values. So we can see we hit OK and apply, and now we have these commas in here. And if we hit OK and OK, and we go back to our layout view, we'll see that reflected in our legend. So already we're halfway there to making our legend a bit more legible.